built. I lead by example. I run my whole city, step aside and get trampled. Rappers getting shelved, their careers on the mantle. And these days you only getting signed if they stamp you. But I don't need postage, I'm really quite focused. A spot away from pocketing the conversation, the dopeness. Fly, but I'm hungry, I guess I'm one of them vultures.
What is up, guys? Welcome to another episode of Maximilian Must Know. This is part 3 of my fragrance collection. The next 25 videos, if you haven't watched the first two, definitely check those out. And specifically the first one so you can learn how I'm doing this. But this is part 3, the next 25, and then hopefully parts 4, 5, and 6 will be up in the next couple of weeks as well. Hoping to do one a week or one every 2 weeks. So let's get right into it with scent number 51. Polo Big Pony 1 or blue, or green I guess. Almost out of this, not much juice left on this fragrance. Nice, fresh, generic, boring fragrance that I sort of wish I had bought, and I'm certainly not going to rebuy. Next up, number 52, Dan is going to love me, and he's going to make sure to watch every video I do now because I have gray flannel, and I actually don't mind it. You can see I have some left. A friend of mine wore this in high school. I liked it then. I like it now. I think it's just a older, refined gentleman fragrance, obviously with violet and citrus, and I think this is a good fragrance. The lavender, I think it's well done. He's probably never going to ever watch another one. Probably going to lose most of the viewing audience with this one, but I don't mind it that much. So number 52, Grey Flannel. Number 53, we have Nautica Original. Not a huge fan of this one either, guys. You can see I've worn a lot of this. I wore this in high school. My mother got it for me for Christmas when I was a sophomore, and so there is a nostalgic factor to that fragrance for me, even though it's generic and sort of boring. Next up, 54, Animal for Men. No, this should not. You should not buy this in place of Amen, Pure Havana, or Pure Malt, but this is for $23. This is a pretty good fragrance. It's a little dated, obviously. But this was one of the first cheapies I got, and I'm a big fan of it. I definitely wear it when it gets colder out. Next up, this is Gucci by Gucci Pour Homme. Their names are really confusing. I got this years ago, probably 6 years ago. You can see I still have some left, haven't gone through it. Not a great fragrance, sort of a vinyl, violety smell. And when this one is done, I won't be restocking that one either. Next up, the only Serge Lutton scent that I own of now. I have one coming that I've ordered that I'm going to be doing a review on. I did a review on this. This is Fille en Aiguille. I didn't want to get Chirgi and review that because I feel like that's just been done to death, but I do like that scent a lot, so I will be getting that in time. But this is a really nice resinous sort of tree sap, piney scent. It means women and pine needles, and that's what it's about. Serge Lutton is a great perfumer. I don't like Musta Kubla Khan, but he's a great perfumer, and that's a really good fragrance. Next up, Dolce & Gabbana Light Blue Living Stromboli. I hate this. To me, this smells like the cologne when you open a magazine and you tear that thing open and you smell it, and it sort of has that paper smell with the fragrance. I totally get that with this one. I got a pretty decent deal on this, but I'm just not a fan of Dolce & Gabbana fragrances right now at all, especially since they reformulated Pour Homme. This is Claiborne for Men. I like the Claiborne fragrances. They have a nostalgic factor as well. This sort of reminds me of the 80s with the red cap and the sort of new wave look. Not a bad fragrance, not great, but if you can find it for like $12 or $13, I think it is pretty good. A Coach Rob recommendation that I am so thankful for Dude for, because I like this better than Neroli Portofino. It's not even close as far as I'm concerned. I love this fragrance. Eau de Cologne by Jean-Franco Ferry. Bergamotto Merino. Amazing, amazing fragrance. Coach Rob is really... 3 I bought from him blind that he recommended. 2 I'm really really happy with. 1 I'm a little disappointed about, but we'll talk about that another time. This is, I have the top for it that just came off, L'Anarchiste by Caron. I don't know what that is. This definitely takes on some age, this bottle. This is okay. I think I'm just starting to come around to L'Anarchiste because at first I was a little confused by it, but now I'm starting to like it. Next up, we have James Bromley Original Eau de Toilette. This is amazing. This is so good. $50. I got this at Pasteur Pharmacy. I've gotten so many compliments on this. A rich, complex, and sophisticated fragrance combining refreshing Italian lemon, bergamot, and sweet lime with an aromatic heart of warm amber, exotic spices, and cedar wood base. Amazing. There's 2 of these, though. One has a black and sort of yellow label. Get this one. This is the really good one. The other one, I don't really know about that one. Next up, a favorite of mine, Midnight in Paris. I like the Eau de Toilette a little bit better than the Eau de Parfum. It feels more wearable. This is an awesome set. Everyone should have this, especially because now it's very easy to find under $50 on FragranceNet and places like that. Awesome, awesome scent, Midnight in Paris. Definitely a staple in my rotation all year round, really. Next up, Polo Black. What can I say about this? Not a huge fan of the Polo fragrances at this point, although I do like this one. It has an ice mango note that's kind of nice. Nautica Blue, a Maurice Roussel scent, obviously. Better than the original Nautica, much better. But again, my beef with these is just the horrendous, horrendous staying power, so I wouldn't recommend getting blue unless you're really a fan of this kind of scents. Next up, we have Cannabis Fresh Santel, sort of an Amen copy, chocolate and patchouli in this one, and sandalwood. And this is the old school bottle, you could tell. I got this a long time ago, and you could tell I've used a lot of it. I probably will be re-upping on this just because it's so different. I do enjoy that one quite well. 4711, another alternative to Neroli Portofino. If you don't want to pay $210 for a fleeting citrus fragrance, this one I think is $10. I like Bergamotto Merino better than 4711, but 4711 is still a pretty damn good fragrance. The Dreamer by Versace, one of my favorite cheapies. To me, it smells like wet tobacco. Love this guy. You can always get it for about $30, so great scent. Versace Blue Jeans, scent I wore in college, not too fond of it now. Powdery, a little bit of citrus. I don't love this one now, but I do like it in my collection, so I'm going to keep it no matter what. Visit by Azzaro, beautiful musk fragrance for a great price. I think I paid like $15 for this, 100 ml, and it's a beautiful sort of smoky musk fragrance, so definitely check that out if you get a chance. Next up, we have Soong. Soong owned by Alfred Soong. This is the real deal soapy fragrance, the original soapy fragrance. This smells exactly like Green Irish Spring or Zest, and it's wonderful for $10 or $15. So definitely, if you have a chance, pick that guy up. Quorum by Antonio Puig. You guys probably know Puig does Prada's fragrances now. They're a Spanish perfume group. This is one of their 80s hits. This is a big, big, ballsy fragrance. You own a room when you walk in with this. It's got a lot of big notes, like most 80s fragrances do. I really like that one. Not much I should have to say about Angel Men Pure Malt. You guys all know about this. I did a review on this. I own it and I like it. Next up, Bulgari Pour Homme Soir. Bought this because a friend liked it. I really don't like it. I think it's just something's wrong. Something's weird with it. It doesn't smell good to me. It's all right. It's all right. And I'm giving it a chance though, but so far I just haven't been a big fan of this scent at all. I think this is the last note. Two more. So first up, Houston Z14. This, you could laugh at this, but this has influenced a lot of fragrances, specifically Spice Bomb by Victor and Rolf, and Italian Cypress by Tom Ford. This is sort of, I think, the originator of those two fragrances. And if you don't have this in your collection, you need to pick it up just to sniff it and really look at a fragrance that was huge in the 80s. Huge. Really, really big and pretty good. I have to say, I enjoy it. And then finally, for this 25... probably maybe my favorite of the group, Live Jazz by Yves Saint Laurent. An amazing, amazing citrus and mint fragrance that just screams spring and summer to me. So definitely check that one out. So that was 50 through 75, guys, I believe. Let me just make sure there's not another one. There is not. That is 50 through 75. We are going to have 75 through 100 next week, hopefully, and then 100. There's three more parts, put it like that. I'm near and close to 150 in fragrances, so there's going to be at least three more parts, and then when those are done, we'll finish, we'll gradually go. When I get another 25, we'll do another part, but I'm going to film four, five, and six in the next couple of weeks, and then stay tuned for the review this weekend of a niche fragrance from New York. Anyway, thank you so much for watching, checking out my collection. More videos on this, obviously. I'm Maximilian, and I must know. One certified, signed, sealed, delivered. And when it's all over, I just pray that I'm remembered. No pretenders in my ventures, I'ma show and prove. Success steady, praying, calling, but I know it's you. Blow a few pounds and let the